Welcome to second part of this tutorial. If you haven't seen the first part, I have given the link in the description of the first part. You can just check it out. Today we will learn how to do the right hand panel. Let's get started. Go to shape tool, then choose the rectangle tool, then draw the rectangle. Then choose the fill layer to gray. Then name the layer. In first part, I have created the two smart objects to get this effect. But we have learned something, no? So I will show you how to get this effect using one smart object. Then convert the layer into smart object by right click and choosing the convert to smart object. Then double click the layer. We are into the smart object. We have to arrange the elements one by one by drag and drop method. Make some adjustments. To change the color tone, go to layer style, choose the hue and saturation. Then apply the layer mask. Then drag the color slider all the way to down. Then drag the another element. Make some adjustments. Then double click on the layer. This will bring up here different layer styles. Then apply the color overlay. Then choose the color. Then hit OK. Then drag the another element. Make adjustments. Like this, drag all the elements and place one by one. Here you can see that around the DNA I created some particles. We need to create it now. Create a new layer and choose the brush. Press F5 to open the brush properties. Then increase the spacing and hardness. Enable the shape dynamics. Then increase the size jitter. Also enable the scattering. Then increase the scatter. Here you can see the changes. Then change the foreground color. Then start painting around the DNA. You can see the particles. Drag the another element, then start placing them one by one. Placing the text, don't forget to flip the text by right click on the transformation and choose the flip horizontal. Save the file and see how it looks in main image. This is how it looks like. Go to Smart Object. We have to add a lines to every text and elements. Choose the pen tool, then change the path to shape, then fill to none, and choose the color to stroke. Then stroke 5 pixels. Then draw the line to the every element like this. Here we have to add a small circle at the tip of the line. So choose the ellipse tool and stroke to none and fill the color. Hold shift for proper proportion. Then place the circle. Now go to File, then Save. Here you can see the results. For glass effect, choose the background. Then bring the opacity to 25%. Here you can see the glass effect. Go to Layer and hit Ctrl T. Then right click, choose the Skew. Then skew the layer until you get a proper proportion and make some adjustments. To apply the thickness to the glass, we need to select the layer. So, hold the Ctrl or Command in the Mac and click on the thumbline of the image. Shit, I did the same mistake again. So go to Select and then Deselect. Go to Smart Object, choose the background and bring the opacity to 100%. Then hit Save. Now hold the Ctrl and click on the thumbline of the image. It will turn into selection. Choose the new layer. Then go to Edit, then Stroke. Then stroke with 12 pixels and choose the color. You can also use the hexadecimal code 808080 for 50% gray. Then hit OK. Here you can see the thickness. Now go to Smart Object, then bring back the opacity to 20%. Then hit Save. Here you can see the result. We need to add a small amount of glow at the edge of the glass. Go to Stroke layer and double click on the blank space. It will bring up your different layer styles. Then enable the outer glow. Then make some adjustments. Here you can see the glowness. Then hit OK. We need to add a circles at the tip of the fingers. So drag the circle. Then scale it down. Then bring the layer to top. and adjust it to the fingers. Then right click and choose the skew. Then skew the layer until you get a proper proportion. Copy the layer and adjust it to other fingers. Then choose the another circle and place it on left hand side finger. Now we have to add small light effect at the center of the circle. So choose the new layer, go to brush tool and choose the smooth brush. And change the foreground color. And just click once at the center of the circle. Do the same to other circles. Then bring down the opacity to 50%. Now it looks great. Our final job is to add mic. I have taken the image using Bluetooth, so it will be helpful for me to add mic. Drag the mic image and scale it down and make some adjustments. Here we have to blend the Bluetooth and the mic, so choose the mask and select the eraser tool. Then just erase the edge of the mic until it blends with background. Rasterize the image, right click and choose the rasterize. Then apply the layer mask. Then duplicate the layer. Then bring the below layer down. Then adjust it. Then hold the control or command on the Mac and click on the thumb line of the image. It will turn into a selection and fill it with black. Then deselect. Then bring the opacity down until it looks like shadow. Now convert the layer into smart object. Then go to filter. Blur, then Gaussian blur. Then increase the radius little bit, then hit OK. Then apply some contrast on the mic. So go to layer style, then choose the levels. Then apply the clip mask, then adjust the levels. To give some interesting look, we have to add red light, like this, small red light. Create a new layer, choose the brush tool, then select the soft brush and make sure that your foreground is white, then click once. Then double click on the blank space, it will bring up the box with the different layer styles. Then enable the outer glow, then change the color to red. Then increase the size, also spread, and make some adjustments until you get a better result. Then hit OK. Then adjust the layer. Now make some contrast and color adjustments on the model. Go to layer styles. Then choose the levels. Then apply the clip mask. Then make some adjustments until you get a better result. Again, go to layer style. Then choose the photo filter. And apply the clip mask. And choose the underwater. Then play with density. Here you can see the difference now. That's it guys. I think today you have learned something. If you like my video, hit a like button and drop a comment in comment box and share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials and hit bell icon to get notification. Stay creative. Bye bye.